Quadratic Equations, Factoring, Level 8. Alright, in this video, we're going to go over an additional example. We're going to solve a quadratic equation of the form ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0, where the coefficient of the quadratic term is greater than 1. Recall that quadratic equations of this form factor into linear expressions of the form the quantity px plus r times the quantity qx plus s equals 0. In addition, the signs of the linear term b and the constant term c determine the signs of r and s. Recall that if both the linear term and constant term are positive, then the sign on r and s are also positive. If the sign on the linear term is negative and that of the constant term is positive, then the value for both r and s will be negative. And lastly, if the linear term is either positive or negative and the constant term is negative, then the values of r and s will have distinct signs. One will be negative and one will be positive. With this in mind, let's go ahead and jump straight into an example. Solve the equation 5x squared minus 13x plus 6 equals 0. Alright, we first notice that we are dealing with a quadratic equation where the coefficient of the quadratic term is greater than 1. To check if it's indeed solvable by factoring, we need to use one of two methods, either by the trial and error method or by the method of decomposition and grouping. Let's first solve it by trial and error. Before we attempt to solve quadratic equations, we need to make sure that it's in standard form, with the degrees of the terms in descending order. Notice that the equation is already in standard form, so this step is done. Next, we create two lists and find the factors of the quadratic coefficient a, in this case 5, and the factors of the constant term c, in this case 6. It is totally up to you if you want to create the tables. They are merely for illustrative purpose. Once you practice enough of these problems, you might be able to do all this work mentally. With that side note, let's go ahead and find the factors for each coefficient. The factors of 5 are 1 and 5, and these cover all the factors of 5. Next, let's find the factors of 6. The factors are 1 and 6, and 2 and 3. These two pairs are all the factors of 6. By finding the factors of the quadratic term 5 and the constant term 6, we essentially found potential values for p, q, r, and s. The next step is to generate all the possible factorizations using these values of p, q, r, and s. Before we carry on this step, let's think about the signs that r and s should attain. Looking at the equation, we see that the linear term is negative and the constant term is positive. This means that the sign on r and s have to be negative because a negative times a negative gives us a positive. With this in mind, let's go ahead and start generating all potential factorizations, using the values 1 and 5 as our p and q, and negative 1 and negative 6 as our r and s. We generate the first factorization, the quantity x minus 1 times the quantity 5x minus 6. The next factorization is obtained by switching the values of r and s. Doing that, we obtain the quantity x minus 6 times the quantity 5x minus 1. Next, we go ahead and use the second pair, 2 and 3. As our r and s. Doing that, we obtain the quantity x minus 2 times the quantity 5x minus 3. And switching r and s, we obtain the quantity x minus 3 times the quantity 5x minus 2. The next step is to find the product of the inner and outer terms. Once again, I'm showing this by using tables, but with enough practice, you can do all these steps mentally. I will continue showing them just to illustrate the process. So for the first factorization, the product of the outer terms is negative 6x, and the inner terms is negative 5x, which add up to negative 11x. The second factorization, outer terms, gives us negative x, and the inner terms gives us negative 30x, and they add up to negative 31x. The third factorization, outer terms, gives us negative 3x, and the inner terms gives us negative 10x, and they add up to negative 13x. The last factorization's outer term gives us negative 2x, and the inner terms gives us negative 15x, and they add up to negative 17x. Next, we scan the list, looking to match the linear term of the quadratic equation, in this case, negative 13x. We see that the third factorization is the one we are looking for, so this quadratic equation is indeed factorable over the integers. Keep in mind that if for some reason we couldn't match the linear term, then that would mean that the quadratic equation is not factorable over the integers, and would most likely be a prime polynomial. Other techniques would have to be implemented to completely solve the equation, but this is not the case with this equation, because it factors into the expression, the quantity x minus 2 times the quantity 5x minus 3. The last step is to apply the zero product property and set each factor equal to 0. and solve for x. Doing that, we obtain x equals 2 as one solution and x equals 3/5 as a second solution. Some students like using this method. Personally, I like to use the method of decomposition and grouping. Let's go ahead and solve the same problem by using the method of decomposition and grouping so we can compare both methods. Alright, we're going to factor this quadratic equation by the method of decomposition and grouping. I personally like this method since it requires less guessing and checking, and you can actually obtain some insights to whether or not the quadratic equation is factorable over the integers. So the first step is to take the coefficient of the quadratic term, in this case 5, and multiply it by the constant term c, in this case 6. Doing that, we obtain 5 times 6, which equals 30. The next step is to list the factors of 30. Once again, before we list the factors, notice that the linear term is negative and the constant term is positive. This means that the values of r and s will both be negative. So we need to list the negative factors of 30. We want to find two factors whose product equals 30. The first pairs are negative 1 and negative 30, followed by negative 2 and negative 15, then negative 3 and negative 10, and lastly, negative 5 and negative 6. Next, we find the sum of each pair. The first pair add up to negative 31, the second pair add up to negative 17, and the third add up to negative 13, and the last pair add up to negative 11. Once again, we're looking for the pair that add up to the linear term, in this case, negative 13. We see that the factors in the third row satisfy this condition. We're going to use these factors in the next step. The next step is the decomposition part of the method. We're going to decompose the linear term negative 13x by using the factors found in the previous step. In this case, negative 3 and negative 10, as follows. Remember, by decomposing the linear term by using these factors, we are rewriting the expression. We haven't changed the problem because of the sum of the two new terms still add up to the linear term negative 13x. The purpose of this step is to create groupings. The next step involves creating two groups, making sure to include a decomposed term and a non-decomposed term in each of the groupings. I'm going to group together the quantity 5x squared minus 3x and group the quantity negative 10x plus 6. Make sure you include a positive sign between both groupings. This is a common mistake that many students make. You have to include a positive sign between the two groups that you form. The next step is to find the GCF of each grouping. For the first grouping, the GCF is x, so factoring that out, we leave behind the quantity 5x minus 3. For the second grouping, the GCF is 2, so we factor that out and leave behind the quantity negative 5x plus 3. Now this step is crucial. We should have obtained a common factor from both groupings. Either we made a mistake during the decomposition step, or we found the wrong GCF in the last step. In this case, it's none of those. Notice that both factors are off by a negative sign. We can easily fix this by factoring out a negative sign from either factor. So keep this in mind, if we have an expression such as the quantity negative a plus b, we can write an equivalent expression by factoring out a negative sign. Doing that, we leave behind the same expression, but with the sign switched. In essence, we factored out a negative sign. So keep this in mind whenever you encounter expressions that differ by signs. You can make them equal by factoring out a negative sign in either expression. So we go ahead and factor out a negative sign from the second factor. Doing that, we obtain the expression 5x minus 3. Now we have equivalent factors from both groupings. This is the end goal of this method, because now we can factor out this common binomial. Doing that, we obtain the quantity 5x minus 3 times the quantity x minus 2. The last step is to apply the zero product property to each factor and solve for x. Doing that, we obtain x equals 2 as one solution and x equals 3/5 as a second solution. Alright, in our next video, we will continue covering additional examples with these two methods.